See, to be aloof, they are always concerned with the devices, the technology, and the actions that we have chosen as individuals, as they're concerned with those things in of themselves, but they're also concerned with the plight of mankind, his history in terms of a humanistic one, and what that may gain us or what that might lead us to. They're always going to be on the forefront and the lookout for what's going to occur next. They know what is in the minds and in the hearts of their fellow man. They can see these things in the clearest of detail and can be quite prophetic in their descriptions and I would say marking of the issues. They can just put their finger on what's going on so strongly and profoundly that we should understand and we should know with the INTJ that they know what is coming in some respects. They know that science and all of the things that are wonderful about what we have done with our insights and our innovations can also be our ruins. As the best scientific writers were ones like Asimov, the ability for them to say what is this world and what is man and what does that mean is probably one of the most salient and profound abilities that we do need in our current age and will always be in need of, as they are the ones that write the tragedy. They are Frankenstein in some respects. They have amazing power and wisdom that comes to them in terms of their intuition and their intellect. They have the vulnerability of their consciousness at the same time. They're sensitive and excitable by this world. They are, they can be enwrapped in the sensual aspects of things and really enjoy the aesthetics. They might want the power over life and death. They might want to create utopias. They might want these things and to see these things and may drive themselves and others to achieve very high maxims and goals. Or they may be like Nietzsche, or they may be like others who see the foolishness in such things and understand that those aren't heights to be achieved. They can be such a range of things and individuals, but the thing that typifies them more so than anything is they're just detectives, and they're the humanist detectives. They understand who they are and what they are, and they're trying to figure out that the same thing out about the world and about people within the world and the greater communities that they're concerned with, and they just don't let this go without consideration, and they never put this down. They will always be the detective, and that's just how they live their lives out, I think, at least. And so I hope I've been fair in this description of the INTJ as to say what it is that they are phenomenologically. I am trying to get to this with all types. I don't want to just come up with traits, but I will stick with biological descriptions and metaphors and include traits in some respects, but talk about the types in terms of what their existence is and what their relation is to humanity in a broader sense, because I think that that's the point of type in some respects. As I have, there's other theories, but anyways, it's just that individuals are what they are in respects to communities, I think. And I just hope that this description has been fair, insightful, and accurate. And if not, you can let me know, and I will try again. But hopefully, it was good, because I've been trying to make it so. And if this video has been a success, I will then turn my attention to INFJs, then the ENFP, and that will wrap up the NFs, and then I will turn my attention to SJs. But I will say this, that it's going to take me time to get each video out, though they're coming slowly. It's going to take time for me to get each video out because I don't want to just talk about the cognitive functions, and I don't just want to talk about, I want to talk about existence, I guess, being in existence. That's my video, and hopefully you found it interesting. Thank you for watching.